Oh, here he comes. He's a nice one. Oh, Lord. Oh, yeah.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Wildcatters TV. Today I'm on the Lake Wilson on the Tennessee River and we're going to try to catch some monster cats today. I've got a new technique that I'm trying out and I'm going to show you how I'm doing it today. Hopefully we can put a little pattern together and get some fish in the boat today. So hang tight while I get my rods out and I'll show you what I'm doing. But first off, I do know when you're trying to put out a bunch of rods, different styles of rods, because we are going to drift some baits today, suspend drift them. We're going to drag some baits, and we're going to suspend drift some baits on the planer boards to get them out away from the boat a little bit. But when you're going to do this, when you're going to try to pull a technique like this, you want to get your boat going at the speed that you're going to be traveling as you're fishing. And right now I'm doing 0.4 mile an hour, so that's about all I want to do right now today. The wind's not blowing too bad, so it might be a good day. But we'll get started with our dragging rods, and then we'll throw our suspended rods out. But we are throwing big baits today. I'm not trying to catch anything small, so we will be throwing some big baits today. But like I say, just keep in mind when you're loading your boat with your baits and your techniques, have your boat moving at the speed and the direction you're going to go in to make it happen. That way you don't get stuff all tangled up. All right. These are some big Tennessee River skipjack. And that's what we're going to use today. Now, I am being a little bit lazy. I should be using a double hook rig on these, but I'm not going to do it just because I'm being lazy today. So, if I lose a fish because I didn't double hook rig it, it's my fault, you know. So, sometimes you need to learn. You got to do things to learn yourself. And when I lose that big fish after a while because I didn't double hook rig it, I'll probably start tying a double hook rig. But it's early in the morning. I'm anxious to get my baits out there. And we're going to drag two rods right on the bottom. In about 70 foot of water, just right behind the boat. We're not gonna throw it out any length. It's just gonna be right under the boat dragging. That way they're gonna be out of the way of everything else that we're gonna have out there. And what I'm fishing here is a submerged island. Everything around me is like 80, 90 foot, but I'm in the 70, 69, 70 foot up on an underwater island. Now, as you're dragging these baits and pulling these baits just in general, you want to check them about every 20, 30 minutes, because what happens when you're dragging across these flats like this, these little fish get in there and just pick in it. So you think you're dragging a big old piece of bait down there, and then the little blue cats have just devoured it, and you just got skin and a little bit of meat. There's a series of islands out here that we will be fishing today. I'm on a small piece that's just kind of, it doesn't probably look like it's going to be 200 feet wide, but it's probably a half mile long. So we're going to drag it first. If we don't do any good there, then we're going to go over to the next island and drag there. All right, my bait's hit the bottom. We're going to put it in the rod holder. And these two are fishing right now, so there's some nice fish on the bottom there. Now, next ones. These are going to be my planer boards. I'm going to go on and get them down on the bottom and put my planer boards on. And get them out of the way. Now, the only thing we're doing is we're using the planer board kind of like a bobber. But the benefit to it is that it's going to kind of go off to the side and give us a more span of of fishing area. And it's hit the bottom. And we'll reel it up a couple times. Find out which is right or left. All right, now what I want to do, there is a left and a right. And we're going to stick that on first onto the line. It's just a swivel with a snap swivel. And we'll put it on the line. And then we're going to pull up here and put the clip on. And that's going to hold it. Like I say, we're already moving at about 0.4 mile an hour. So that's just going to try to drag these baits off to the side. And once I get them where I want them, we lock it down and put it in the rod holder and just wait. Now some guys will like to put these things 200-300 feet back behind the boat and really make a big spread, but I don't want to do that. I want to leave about 10 foot of space, 10-15, give or take a little bit of space between each bait I have on my boat. Like when we put this one out, it's going to be the farthest one. The next one out is going to be my just my down rod, my suspended rod. And then another 10 foot in comes my dragon rods. So when I hit about a 40 foot swath that's coming down through this island, there's only going to be about 10 foot between each bait as I drag it behind the boat. But that's just my preference so far. I'm still learning these planer boards. This one's ready to go. I would just let enough line out to get it kind of equal with this other one. I think it just gives me a little bit more control having them closer to the boat, to where I can maneuver over these ledges and stuff and know that I've actually hit my targets. It looks like it's going to be a great day. As long as this wind stays low like it is, I think we're going to be all right. All right, we'll put my other two down rods out, and we'll be cooking. Turning your trolling motor on and keeping it rolling as you're deploying your baits is gonna help you a lot to keep things straight, especially when you fish by yourself. Now that we're all deployed, we just set our course, concentrate on that course, and wait for the bite. Hang tight, guys, we're gonna catch some fish. All right, our first one is on the planer boards. And we'll try to handle him here and get him out of our other blinds. Where these tangled catfish poles come in good. They've got that backbone to control these fish where you want them to go. Good. So far, so good. Big baits, big fish, guys. Here he comes, look at this. Woo! He don't like that planer board. All right, not too bad for our first fish of the day. Guys, we haven't been out 15 minutes yet, and we've already nailed this one. So it looks like it may be a good day. I don't want to jinx myself, but woohoo! We're all over fish. And like I say, guys, you can see I'm just drifting on these underwater islands. Be a wild man. Let me make sure everything is up. All right. That's our first one. First one of the day. Oh. You know what? All right, guys, we're going to throw him back. Oh. There we go. Well, down it goes. Come on. Fight it, buddy. There he goes, straight to the bottom. All right, that's gonna hurt. That's gonna really hurt. All right, we're gonna put another big piece of bait out and get this one out and see if we can catch fish number two. Man, that's gonna hurt today. There's another one trying on the dragon rod again. Is he big enough to get it in his mouth though? He done swam with it. Way over here. He's in front of the boat. Now this was the dragon rig. There he is. They're locking them heads today. Let me get my net. enough line. Come here, come here, come here, come here. One on a dragon rig, guys. Like I say, when you're pulling these multi techniques, it pays off a lot of times. But you can also use this multi technique to find out what the fish are wanting. If they're wanting anything, it's game on. But sometimes they're just going to want something on bottom, and other times they're just going to want something suspended. So. But as you can see, guys, big baits, they can get them in the mouth real easy. When they're hungry, that's what they want. All right, guys, you gotta love it when you got action going on, but here's number two, half hour into our trip. There you go, buddy. Woo! If this ain't a lot of fun, I don't know what is. Bloody knuckles, slime. What else you need? All right. I hadn't even finished getting this other suspended planer border line back out from the first fish, and the second fish hit. So, let me finish getting this one out. And we're just gonna work these underwater islands this morning and this afternoon, today. Planer board. Oh, he comes straight off. He comes straight off. Let's see what happened. Should have double hooked him, Steve. You'd have caught that fish. All right, man, I can hear it, guys. But hey, we're fishing. We're fishing. Ain't nothing wrong with the hook. The hook's sharp as heck. Nothing wrong. He just don't know what happened. Don't know. He wasn't all that big, so that might have been part of it. Because it's such a big bait, he was probably smaller than the rest of them because he was just coming in too easy. Hey, but hey, we're on them. We're on them. We're on them. I figure I can show you my triumph. I can also show you my defeats, and right there, fellas, was a defeat. But we got another piece of bait. We got another piece of bait. Man. But we don't know. It could have been because I don't have a double hook rig. All you can do is bait them up and get them back out there. As far as the boards are concerned, it's a little inconvenience to have to take the boards off, work with the boards, but I can definitely see a benefit in these boards. I'm gonna look into them a little deeper. You know, there's a lot of guys that have been using these boards for quite some time, and I've known about them for years, but, uh-oh. But I guess I'm a lazy fisherman. I don't like tackle. I don't like to fool tackle. but I like to catch fish, and doing tackle's part of it. So if this is just another piece of tackle that you can put in your arsenal. Now there is another fellow out there in the internet world, somewhere I think he's in North Carolina, by the name of Zach Royce. This guy actually caught two state records within a 24-hour period, which was kind of cool. Now I don't know if he was using these boards or not, but he's kind of known for using the boards on the internet with Facebook and all that. So I've been seeing a lot of that, and you know, other guys using them around, so I thought I'd give them a try. I'm kind of glad I did. So you can teach old dogs new tricks, that's for sure. All right, guys, slow and steady. I'm keeping it at about 0.5 mile an hour right down this ridge. And we're on some fish. See a few here and there. Keep on course. We're gonna run this ridge for about another 20 minutes. If I don't get another bite, then I'm gonna jump over onto the bigger island right here, where I caught some fish yesterday, and we're gonna run that for a while. All right, when you're packing up to move to another spot, also keep in mind, keep that trolling motor exactly where you were. Keep yourself on course. Don't turn your trolling motor off just because you're stopping, because your lines are all stretched out behind your boat still. And you don't want that mess to occur when you stop your trolling motor, and it all just gets tangled. So keep on course, reel your stuff in, and you'll do a lot better with keeping the tangles out of your life. Once you get all your lines up, then you can cut the trolling motor off and head to your next spot. Just a little trick I found to keep a mess eliminated. See there, guys? That's another reason why you want to change your baits about every 30 minutes. Because those little guys, those little blue cats, little anything that's scavengers down there, this is sliding along the bottom, and they're just sitting there pecking at it. So now we don't have nothing but gill plates here. So we'll start all over. All right, we got the last one up. We can lift the trolling motor up. We're good to go. There's our last bait out of the water. Nothing ever touched it either. So let's head over to this other larger underwater island and pull a little drift over there. All right, guys, we've just now jumped over to another island, and we're kind of concentrating in the 70-foot mark. But the fishing has gotten slow a little bit, so what we're going to do is expand our search some. So instead of running two planer boards like I was this morning and making like a 40-foot swath through a section, I'm now probably going to be up more or less sitting around 75-foot coming through a big open flat here. And hopefully we can attract some fish that way. Okay, that's it. Now we're pulling four boards, and we're going to just pull these across this big flat also and see what we can come up with. Hopefully there's a big boy down there ready to nail one of them. And we're still dragging two. So we just added a set of boards is all we've done. And expanded our reeks somewhat. Now we wait. think he's a doozy, but they can't all be big. But he nailed that planer board. We're gonna pull him up easy, just because they're down deep. And I know if you guys have ever watched any of my other videos, you know you gotta pull them up slow because they gotta decompress from being in all that deep water. If you don't, they build some kind of gases up and just float on top of the water. Yeah, this is not a big fish at all, but he probably hit a big head. He probably thinks he's big. He might be better size than I think. He's trying to pull drag now. What if he just didn't know he wasn't hooked? I haven't seen any bubbles yet. There he is. He still hasn't blowed yet. Boards out of the way so we don't break them. That's a pretty decent fish. He just thinks he's big. He's been eating a lot. All right, guys. Planer boards, they help you a lot. I'm starting to believe in them. And I think I'm going to put them in my arsenal. You, buddy. Man, they've been eating good. I'm gonna show you one more time how to load these boards up. First off, I've got just a simple Carolina rig that I'm using. 65 pound braided line, a swivel, 8 ounce no roll sinker. Again, guys, it does not have to be a no roll. It can be a slip sinker of some sort, egg sinker, and then a 10-aught octopus circle hook. And I'm just gonna stick this piece of bait in. So I've got probably a pound or a pound and a half on this line right now as it is. So what we're gonna do is just drop it down to the bottom. And the reason I use this 8 ounce too is because I want control of that thing. I want that bait down there where I put it as I'm pulling it. And we're just gonna drop it directly to the bottom. All right. Now that we hit bottom, we're gonna reel our tip of our rod all the way into the water. Then give it 2 or 3 cranks. We know where it's at. So that's going to put us about 3 to 5 foot up off the bottom. We're going to load this board on the little clip. There is a right and left hand board also, guys. And now we're just going to clip this to the line. And let her out. We'll let just a little bit of line out. And and we're just going to cruise across this flat. All right, plainboard fish. They've slowed up today for some reason. Come on, here he comes. He's decent. Oh, get out of my line. Get out of my line. He sure is a keeper. Don't want to hit this net yet. There's another 40. We've got several 40s today, nothing real big, but always worth catching these bad boys. Another planer board fish. I'm liking the planer boards. Come here, come here. Oh, come here. Oh, Lord. There it is. They were like that big hook. Whoa, buddy. Whoa, whoa. All right, let me get straightened up and see where I'm at. Everything's still good. Mean one. All right, guys, here's what you can do with these planer boards. It ain't nothing new, it's just new to me. They've been around for years. I just think it's a very underutilized technique. Very underutilized technique. All right, there we go. Another good fish. Oh, he's nice and ready to go back in. All right, guys, we're gonna go eat some lunch and come back out this afternoon, but I just wanted to take a little time here and show you what I'm doing with the planer boards. If you have any questions, you can address that in the comments below. I'll try to answer anything I can. Remember, February 25th, 26th, Catfish Conference, Louisville, Kentucky. We'd like to see you there. And again, thanks for stopping by to watch our videos. If you haven't subscribed, please do so now. And we'll see you in the next one.